Hello, dear learners. In this presentation, we are going to see the beta-lactam antibiotics in detail. As in earlier presentation, we have already seen what are antibiotics. Then the first antibiotic, that is the penicillin, we have studied its structure and mode of action. And now in this presentation, we will study the classification of antibiotics on its chemical structure, particularly the beta-lactam antibiotics in detail. So, let's see. Learning outcomes of this presentation are, after completely viewing this presentation, the learner will be able to recall antibiotics and outline different pharmaceutical organic compounds belonging to beta-lactam antibiotics. The content of this presentation are, first, introduction to antibiotics. Then, in this presentation, we are going to see two important subclasses of beta-lactam antibiotics, that is penicillin derivative and cephalosporin derivative, and study the given examples respectively. So let's see what are antibiotics in short. So, definition: antibiotics are the chemical substances produced by various species of microorganisms, and they are used to inhibit the growth of other species of microorganism. On the basis of chemical structure, these antibiotics are classified as beta-lactam antibiotics and non-beta-lactam antibiotics. So, in this presentation, we are typically going to focus on beta-lactam antibiotics, and non-beta-lactam antibiotics will be discussed in upcoming presentations. So, beta-lactam antibiotics. The beta-lactam antibiotics, this classification mainly indicates that these antibiotic drugs have the structure of or consist the beta-lactam ring in this structure. Here we can see that this four member ring, that is N, C, C and C double bond O, this four member ring is nothing but the beta-lactam ring, which is either fused with 5-membered sulfur-containing ring or 6-membered sulfur-containing ring. If the beta-lactam ring is fused with 5-membered sulfur-containing ring, then the structure is called as penicillin. And if it is beta-lactam ring is fused with 6-membered sulfur-containing ring, then the structure is known as cephalosporin. And here mentioned are the examples of both penicillin and cephalosporin. So let's study now these examples in detail. So first example is benzyl penicillin, which is the penicillin derivative. Then the synonym for benzyl penicillin is penicillin G and penicillin G sodium. In this structure, this complete structure is the structure of benzyl penicillin. Why this structure is called as benzyl penicillin? Because at the sixth position, here is the presence of benzyl group. The benzyl group is attached to the amido group, which is present at the sixth position. So this penicillin is called as benzyl penicillin. The chemical name for benzyl penicillin is 6-2-phenylacetamidopenicillanic acid. Its color, it is white crystalline powder, odorless, bitter, and it is very soluble in water. To maintain the stability of benzyl penicillin, it is stored in airtight, light resistant containers. Uses: it is used as antibiotic. It is used in treatment of different infections like syphilis, gonorrhea, pneumonia, and scarlet fever. It is known by the different brand names like Pentids, Permapen, Pfizerpen, Vicillin, etc. Then the next example is phenoxymethyl penicillin. It is known by the synonym penicillin V. The chemical name for phenoxymethyl penicillin is 6-2-phenoxyacetamidopenicillanic acid. It is white crystalline powder, odorless and tasteless. It is very soluble in water It is slightly soluble in water and soluble in chloroform and ether. Phenoxymethyl penicillin, it is used as broad spectrum antibiotics to treat gonorrhea and pneumonia. It is known by the brand names such as Bipen VK and Bitapen VK. Next example is ampicillin. So ampicillin is also called as 6-2-amino-2-phenylacetamidopenicillanic acid. Ampicillin is a white crystalline powder which is odorless and has a bitter taste. It is insoluble in water and soluble in chloroform and ether. Ampicillin is stored in airtight and light resistant containers and kept in cool place to maintain its stability. Uses: ampicillin is used as antibiotic and it can be used in treatment of gonorrhea, meningitis, enteric fever, respiratory tract infection and also urinary tract infections. It is known by the brand name as Unicin. Next penicillin derivative is benzathine penicillin. Benzathine penicillin is a white hygroscopic powder and odorless. As it is hygroscopic, solubility studies, it is very slightly soluble in water, alcohol, ether and chloroform. As it is hygroscopic, the benzene penicillin, it is to be stored in tightly closed light resistant container and must be stored at the temperature below 25 degrees Celsius. Uses: it is used particularly to treat infection caused by gram-positive bacteria like actinomycetes, bacillus anthracis, etc. It is known by the brand names as Penidur and Lonasilin. Next example is cloxacillin. Cloxacillin is a white crystalline hygroscopic powder which is odorless and has a bitter taste. solubility studies concludes is that it is soluble in water, it is sparingly soluble in alcohol, and very slightly soluble in chloroform. Cloxacillin is to be stored in airtight containers and protected from light and stored at temperature below 25 degrees Celsius. It is also used as antibiotics and is known by the brand names as Cloxa-A and Cloxin. Next example is carbencillin. Carbencillin is also a white hygroscopic powder which is odorless and has a bitter taste. It is soluble in water and alcohol and practically insoluble in chloroform and ethers. It is stored in airtight containers and protected from light. Carbencillin, it is used as an antibiotic in penicillin G resistant species. It is used to treat urinary tract infection and also used in treatment of Pseudomonas infection. It is known by the trade name as Geoslin and Carbedin. Next example is the cephalosporin derivative is cephalexin. Cephalexin is a white or cream colored crystalline powder with characteristic odor. It is sparingly soluble in water and very slightly soluble in chloroform and alcohol. It is stored in tightly closed light resistant containers at temperature not more than 30 degrees Celsius. Uses of cephalexin are, first use, it is used as antibiotic or antibacterial agent. It is used to treat urinary tract infection, respiratory tract infection. It is also used to treat skin and soft tissue infection, to treat bone and joint infection and dental infection. It is known by the brand names as Cefexim, Neosef and Cefaxin. Then cephaloridin. Cephaloridin is a white crystalline powder which is odorless or has a slight odor of pyridine and has a bitter taste. Cephaloridin is freely soluble in water and very slightly soluble in chloroform. It is stored in tightly closed light resistant container at a cool place. Similar to cephalexin, cephaloridin is also used as antibiotic and antibacterial agent to treat different infections like urinary tract infection, respiratory tract infection, skin and soft tissue infection and so on. It is known by the brand names as cephalodin and cefadin. Last example is of this presentation is cephalothin. So cephalothin, it is a white crystalline and odorless compound. It is freely soluble in water and practically insoluble in chloroform. It is stored in tightly closed light resistant container at temperature not more than 25 degrees centigrade. Uses: it is used as antibiotic and antibacterial agent to treat urinary tract infection, respiratory tract infection, bone and joint infection. It is known by the brand names as Keflin and Cefin. So here we conclude this presentation. I hope you must have understood the different examples of beta-lactam antibiotic. So let's discuss non-beta-lactam antibiotics in further upcoming presentation. Thank you.